Hi guys, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Monster Hunter Portable 3rd for PSP. And this is... I'm not sure what part it is, but it's the... Finally the Baleful Giganox, and... I'm gonna use a bow on it. I do not have any good... That I can remember, any good water gear that's melee. If I had a... water set and actually we can check that real fast. Hope it doesn't take too long to check because this one probably take a while with a bow and it's easier than the normal Giganox, but it hit very hard. It can sometimes if you got bad gear one shot you. Let's see, armor craft. Let's see if we can do the Viking melee set here. I'm missing depth light ore, that's gonna take a while to farm. I think I'm actually gonna do that, but not now. I'm gonna go ahead and do this with a bow. Otherwise, depth light ore will probably just take me an hour or something to get the needed ones for that set, but then I gotta upgrade it and stuff like that. Make a weapon that actually uses water, preferably sword and shield or something like that against it. I'm not that good with the two-handed sword in this game, actually suck with it. In Unite, I really loved. Oh my god, did I say sword and shield? I meant two-handed sword. I'm not sure if I said that right there. In Unite, I actually almost only used two-handed the great sword. What the hell? I want to attack up medium. I'm gonna see if I have space to bring Demon Dragon armor skin as well. This one is weak to water and dragon. Let's see if I can do a demon drag. I don't think I can do armor skin, but I should be able to do demon drag. I have another spot free here. What could I bring? God. I almost forgot traps. Okay. I think that's good to go. Kinda wasted 3 minutes there. Don't like this, and I definitely do not like the next map. My god, that's the Baleful Giganox. He's right behind me. There's also, if I remember right, a fucking Lagombe somewhere. Pain in the ass. This is pretty much like the Kiesu, actually. It's a lot like the Kiesu. He takes the most damage in the face when he's not enraged. I think, yes, the... I heard the Lagombe, I think, no. I think it's pretty much like the... I can't see right now. Pretty much like the normal one, the back legs and the stomach and when enraged, the... the tail and when not enraged. The face. I could have brought poison probably. I just figured it would be... wasn't gonna take that much damage from poison. Oh my god, that was fast and he missed. Close call. I liked Kiesu, so in a way I like this one a lot more than I like the other Giganox. Kinda split into three as you said there. So there, sorry about that. Can't speak today. Good thing with using a bow, as I noticed on the other Giganoxes, that you're pretty safe. And that's the kind of move that you saw there, that's pretty similar to Kiesu's move, when they kind of jump a little bit forward, glowing a little bit. No! Those little Kiesus, they can actually, when they grow large, when they suck enough blood or whatever it is, they can start spitting poison on you. It's pretty nasty. I'm using the exact same gear that I used in the other video with Steel Uragan. I noticed this one was also weak to water, so just went for that. He doesn't turn black when enraged, instead it turns red. And yeah, that's another Kiesu move right there. Kiesu copycat. You're a copycat, Giganox. Copycat. Actually, I would have rather seen Kiesu than another Giganox. Just a bit more variety of monsters. It shouldn't have been that hard to bring along. Oh no, he's gonna get me. Oh, that was close. Oh my god. Those actually hurt a lot if you get hit by them. That's enraged. It's a lot cooler than a normal Giganox. And it's a lot easier as well, because he just stun you instead of actually putting a poison on you that does like 100% health. It's the back legs and back that I want to hit him in now. Not sure how long this will take. Probably 25 minutes. Ooh. Ooh. This is somewhat enjoyable. But that's because I'm using a bow. I would be furious if I was using a melee weapon, because he is everywhere. It's rather ugly. He can't fly, even though he's supposedly very heavy. If you read the wiki, he should be very heavy because of all the flabby skin. Which you also get from Kiesu. It's leaving. A common trait for these species. They are cowards. And I'm kind of a coward right now as well. Using a bow. It's oh my god, fuck. I thought he was behind me there. Oh no! Ah, he got me. Not good, not good. Cat. Pizza, get me! Get me, pizza! Oh, okay. I didn't need help there. I guess I got a debuff that kind of makes me take more damage from lightning. That was the wing I was kind of talking about. Wings last time, it's usually the wing that get you when he jumps. Can't really see how he's turned on the shadow. And the shadow is smaller than he is, so. Yeah, that's good. Fry those buggies for me, because I hate them. They sleep. I've died a lot of times because of those nasty little suckers. The same with Genprey in Unite, so also rather annoying. 3 coatings left. Watch that. Okay, so right now it's actually its tail, kinda. Oh my god, look how fast it is, kinda. Just jumped away from that arrow there. So, Matrix Giganox. Agent Giganox. And, yeah, this is also rather boring. It's a boring fight. The fastest way to see which is the front and back on this one is by watching the wings. Of course, it's an easy way. Sometimes it's confusing when you are gonna hit the back and don't know which is his front and back. He's gonna spit a bunch of these lightning balls. Whoopsie. Whoopsie. How could I miss the head there? Thought I was actually aiming for it. Stomach and the back legs, that's the easiest part to kinda hit him. Now it's the tail. You can use bounce bombs to bomb him up in the roof when he's there, but it's a little bit risky because he can do a lot of shit from the ceiling. Did he drop a shiny? I think he did. No! Ouch! Get me! Ouch! Hit me, bug! Hit me! Hit me! I think he's leaving. Not 100% sure, but I kinda got the feeling that he's gonna leave soon. Ah! Not again. Yeah, I've been watching too much Futurama. The episode I saw was with, if you ever seen Futurama, the one where Amy is gonna take her Doctor Gray, what's it called? XM, maybe. And there is one of those judging her that's got one of those strings you pull in, and there's an arrow going around, and it says the cow says moo. No one said the doctorship denied, or it says something like that. Pretty funny. Really like Futurama. Just suck at describing what happened there. You got to see it yourself. And I'm a bit focused on that shiny that's on the ground there. I really want that, but it's defending it. The moment I'm gonna go down and either drink a potion or try and take the shiny, it's gonna jump on me. I just know that. I also need new coatings. Is it still there? Did it take too long? He defended it long enough for me to not get it. That fucking sucked. Oh no, I'm not sure. I don't think it's a good idea to make him go into a trap. Actually on the an ogre, that's a very bad idea, because you actually get buffed from going into the... the shock trap. Oh my god, that bug! It's kind of high level bug there. I'm not sure with the Giganox if it also get buffed by going into the shock trap. I'm not gonna try. Did it leave? Oh my god, it's all that I was eating, so it's coming back for more. It's flying. What the fuck is going on here? Okay, left. Ah, fucking bye. Sixteen minutes, don't think this will be done in 20, probably 25 to 30 minutes. Sorry about that. Shark team going on. It's pretty good, the team. I did like the, I said it before, I did like the Unite music a little bit more, even though some of them are the same, I think, overall. But that could be because that was the first game I played Monster Hunter. There is a little bit larger variety of monsters in Unite as well. Not sure why there is not that much here, because I can't really see how... Oh my god! Oof. I wanted to jump, but I can't really see how that can be a problem to set in to portable third. Maybe they are kind of it's so Diablo looks kind of manga, anime. And so maybe they kind of redo the sculpts of the monsters. And that would explain it. I'm not sure why they messed up the Diablos. I think it looks worse. It looked a lot better in Unite, if I remember right. Maybe I'm wrong and it looks exactly the same, but I thought that when it... in this game it looks a bit cartoon. Overall the game is a little bit more cartoon, I think. When you kind of fall, you... Oh my god! Fall! When you fall, you just... grab a hold of the ground and kind of slide across the ground in this game, while in Unite you kind of roll like crazy and get lying there for a while. It really looks like you get hit hard in Unite. You're a bit more superhuman here. Okay, so he didn't go here. I wonder where he went. I didn't see. Fuck, I didn't see. I should have paintballed him. I thought like, oh my god, I'm not gonna need to paintball this sucker. He only goes between a few areas. I think it takes a little bit longer because I'm actually hitting the back instead of the stomach. I think you have to be very direct at hitting the stomach. And it's a lot, it's quite thin, shape of it. It's disgusting. Disgusting leech thing. He flinched. I don't even think I've broken anything on it. That's a bad sign. So we only do one type of egg, and that's that egg right there. That's the kind of one that explodes and you get shocked. You do not do anything else. Oh my god, fucking little leeches. Okay, so now his head is soft and the tail is hard, and when it's red, it's the other way around. I said it a couple of times, but it's easy to forget. Might have said wrong a couple of times as well, but it's when it's not enraged, it's the head. When it's enraged, it's the tail. So now it's the tail. Actually takes very little damage in the face, so it's not even worth trying to hit him there. My god, did you see that? I didn't notice them till now, but wasn't those blue instead of yellow? I think that means they do more damage. I didn't notice that till now actually. I've done quite a few of these. Baleful Giganoxes. Never thought about the color of those. The Kiesu instead kind of do a wider attack. Boring monster, very boring, and ugly. It's gonna be good when this is over with, so I can actually get to HR6. If I can beat the two fucking Snogers. It should start limping, so even if I just beaten it all over, it should kind of end zone. I'm out of coating, I think I'm out of coating. Yes. I should have brought poison coating as well. Let's figure that he would be kind of immune to that in some way. But I kind of forgot that it's a baleful Giganox, not a normal one. This is time consuming. Fucking being up in the roof the entire time. And then trying to jump on him. He's leaving. I didn't paintball him, of course. I forgot again. Next time I will not forget. Mainly goes between area 4 and then down. on the left side of the map. I don't remember what they are called. It can be on other places as well. It can be here. So I'm gonna check here because it kind of came from the other side. It's pretty slow. That's a another Kiesa thing. The Kiesa is extremely slow. Maybe it went here. No. Fuck. Okay. Here. There is. This is a kinda isn't here very often. Honestly, that's quite rare. What the fuck? And I got pigs. It's like the all the nasty shit in the entire game is collected at this map. You got pigs, the little leeches, you got buggy. Even got the most thing on Tekka that can do their best to mess with you. And what else do you got? I'm sure there are more shit. Let's look at those pigs. They really want attention. I'll try and hit the fucking pig as well a little. It basically takes no damage at all from that. Cat finally killed it. It was a fucking hit for fuck's sake. It's a bit tricky to get away from these. Look at how... What a pussy he is. He's a coward. Kind of just spams shitty ranged moves and jumps backwards. Yeah! Okay, maybe they're actually weaker. I thought they were stronger, but... We didn't even get zapped. So in 30 minutes. Thank you, pig. Thank you a lot. Because of that, I'm gonna fucking kill. Oh my god, yeah, that little health left. And I couldn't paintball the fucking Giganox again. Need to learn how to use paintballs. Probably went to one of the caves. Or here. This here is his kind of favorite area, so let's check here as well. Put in note to myself. Paintball the fucking Giganox. Okay, so maybe this is his kind of eat bone area. I'm getting exhausted now. This is taking too long. I'm pretty sure this would have gone faster with a sword and shield. Even if not with water. Usually I just use fire on it, but it doesn't take that much fire. This is the first time I'm using water. It says that it's weak to it, but I don't really feel like it's weak to water right now. It it should be, since it's kinda electric. But it doesn't really feel like it. I must be doing something wrong. This is taking longer than it should. Oh my god, fucker! Being up in the roof. Lovely. Okay, I'm gonna start with hitting the back legs constantly. Because that should be where he's weakest the most during the entire time. It's pretty hard with the bow to hit that. My god! Stomach punishing time! I nuked that stomach of his. No! What the fuck? You went up fast! I need... Okay. I got some payback there. I think he's wounded actually. It sounds like that when he's wounded, so I'm gonna capture him and end this at around 33 minutes. I did bring a trap, I know I did. Even two, that's great. No, I'm capturing a lot of monsters, but it takes quite long to kill this solo. What the fuck did I do that? I thought I had a trap. No bike.
Kiki Nox.
He's leaving me. God. He's basically in it, but fucking Nox. Want to kind of move in to the trap, please? Please! My god. Fucking Giganaut. Oh my god, seriously? Finally. Okay, that wasn't fun at all. Actually, I think I'm gonna have more fun at the next one. Which should be urgent. Two Sinnohers. And probably gonna have to use Sword and Shield on that. Because I don't have a good bow set for them, even though they are a lot easier with bow. Since they got a lot of melee attacks. No. Well, I'm saying all monsters can have, but this one don't do much melee stuff, you can just shoot, but. Sinnohers, you know what that is, it's a wide range of attacks that's pretty hard to avoid. Isn't there one more area? Yeah, there is one over there, but I couldn't get there in time. Oh, so that was the baleful Giganox, the slow way. I am sure there are faster ways to kill that sucker, because this took way longer than... I actually thought it would take 25 to 30 minutes, but it took longer than that. But I'm not gonna try and tweak it down. God, because I hate this one. Oh, it was a gold crown, okay. There you go. That's why it took longer. Didn't look like a gold crown, but it was a small gold crown. I'm gonna end this here because it's over 35 minutes, and the next time I'm pretty sure we will do the Tosin Ogres. Let's check. We can do that. Yes. Tosin Ogres! My god. Okay. Well, that's the next quest. I'm gonna take a break for today because I need to be focused for that one. And that is the end of this video. Thank you for watching. If you like my videos, please comment, rate and subscribe. See you next time.